Hola! Hi, Rushers! Okay, usually I would say Allison Schmidt, but lately, if I'm gonna be completely honest, I've been having these, like, serious Logan feels. Like, I don't know. And you know what else? Like, it's getting so bad, I can't even call Big Time Rush as their real names. Like, Kendall will be Kindle or K3 or Kendizzle. I think I mainly call him, like, Kindle, because it's just adorable. For Logan, I just call him Loki, because, you know, his dimpled face, like, in his eyes, and he's just so cute, and you just have to call him Loki. For James, Maslow, or, you know, Jabs. Okay, Jabs are something that I made up, and Jabs are James abs, because they're abs, but they're James's abs. Jabs. Hi, Bandit. And then for Carlos, it's just Los. Los. Okay. I did get a request to do this video, which is like the first request ever, so I feel famous. No, I'm just kidding. It is the 24/7 album review, and this is gonna be fun because all those songs on there are party songs. Thank you, Hender Hoare. First song is obviously 24/7. So here we go. Okay, the first time I heard that song, I was like, oh, this is so cool. It has a cool sound to it. And I really like the name. The name is really cool for the album. I don't know, when the album actually came out, I was like, you know what, this isn't like the best song on here. It's so much fun, but it's not like my favorite. But now that it's like grown on me, and then they have a little finger dance, like 24/7, that song is my jam. Like, seriously, it's a perfect summer song, party song, and it's amazing, so, I don't know. I just think that's, like, a fun song to dance to. It'd be fun to make a music video to it, maybe. That would be really fun. Maybe I should do that. Next song! Okay. This song is like the sweetest song ever. I know Big Time Rush, like, they write all their songs like kind of separately. Like, Jarlos will write one song and then Kogan will write another. And then there's Logan, who just writes his inappropriate songs that Nickelodeon won't allow. Like, Nobody's Around, I know that one of their only songs on the album that they all four of them wrote together. So I think that really means a lot to them. So it tells their story too, like their whole journey. Like, it's weird because, you know, like, they're trying to beat the haters. It's for the Rushers. So that one is really amazing, and I love it when they perform it live because it's acoustic and then it's just so pretty. Dustin's there. Something weird happened to me last night. I literally had a dream about Dustin's mustache. I'm not even kidding, though. It's the weirdest thing ever. I had a dream about his dustache. Okay, Bandit thinks I'm weird. Okay, I don't know really what it was, but I was like at the movies, and then the next thing I was like somewhere else. I was like at a park or something. I don't know what the heck that means, but I kept seeing Dustin there. And then I saw, apparently he was my neighbor. Like, what the heck? Apparently he was my neighbor. I live in Florida. Like, that wouldn't happen. I was chilling with his mustache, and then I went up to him and I pet his mustache. It was weird. I have the weirdest dreams. I stay up late, like, all night, and sometimes I have to wake up early, like today. I got, like, no sleep. I don't know. It's ow! Maybe lack of sleep has something to do with weird dreams. Okay, next song. Still Asleep and Yet. So, that song is my jam! I know I said that about 24/7, but this song is like legit my jam. Every time I hear it, I have to like fist pump or just dance around and stuff. Cause like the first time I ever heard this song, like, I was home alone and I blasted it so loud and I was dancing and singing and going crazy all around my house. And I was like insane. I probably listened to this like 100 times an hour or something, no joke. But seriously, this song just makes you want to like get up and dance. I'm in a different area, by the way. I am in my living room. There is a painting right above my head of, I think that's someplace in Paris, you know? I really don't know. Okay. Oh, I woke him up. I'm sorry, Banjo. We haven't gotten to my favorite yet. You'll probably see when I freak out if you know what my favorite is. Next song. Oh, you see me. Okay, this song, I love this song. Like, Song For You, there's no one in this world who can hate that song. It's just like has a really cool beat to it and a really cool sound, and I love the Carmen rap. Oh my god. I mean, I didn't even know it would have been better if Logan rapped in it. Which I did. I heard that apparently Big Time Rush does have new music coming out sometime in the future. But I know that Victoria Justice was gonna like rap on one of their songs. Like, Nickelodeon wants them to be a team. No. Come on, Logan is the Hender whore with the Hender swag. Doesn't it make sense if he raps? Like, what the heck? The only closest thing we got to rapping was Love Me Again. And Nickelodeon changed that. Nickelodeon just ruins everything. Next song. Okay, I'm gonna be honest, the first time I did hear the song, I was like, eh, it's okay. You know, I didn't think it was ever gonna be my favorite. I guess all the songs kind of grow on you, and then you really start deciding which one is your favorite, if you do have a favorite. I know it's like super duper hard to choose. Super duper hard! Super duper hard! That's what he's like. All day. He usually is not asleep at this time, but he is. What song were, oh, Run Wild. Okay. So, that song didn't used to really be one of my favorites. Probably like one of my least favorite on the album, actually. Like, if you haven't seen Big Time Rush Live, just still love this song. Because it's so cool and it just makes you have like all this energy. And I guess it does really have a good meaning to it. But I know seeing it live definitely kind of made me love this song. That was probably a fail, but that was Crazy For You. That was the first song I think I heard on this album. Was it? You know what? That song was always gonna be a favorite for everybody, just because, I don't know, it's a Kendall song. He actually told us at the Universal concert that he wrote this song. No, James told us that Kendall wrote this song for a girl. A girl. But then he said apparently something like didn't really work out, so now it's for the Rushers. They said it was kind of like an old song too, so I don't know when it's from. But I know Confetti Falling was before Elevate. Like it was supposed to be on the Elevate album, but it didn't really match the sound, so they didn't put it on it. So they did for 24/7, and I love it. But Crazy For You, once I heard that song, I just had to like jump on my guitar and just like try to figure everything out. And I did actually figure out how to play it. I don't know if it's the right chords, but it does sound like it. It just puts you in the zone, and you just want to like make out with Kendall's face, or you just want to make out with all their faces. Like, next song. Just Okay, that was Picture This, and honestly, at first I was like, I really liked it. And then when I heard the other songs, I was like, this isn't my favorite. I think anyone would have liked it more if they did perform it live on the tour, which I wish they did. I wish they performed all their songs. No, in a way, I do blame Nickelodeon just because they're like holding them back. Picture This, Carlos wrote it. I think Carlos wrote it, or maybe it was Jarlos. I don't know, there's not much to say about this song. He wrote it, like, about Alexa, or maybe he didn't. I really don't know. Next song! I didn't want to stop that song. Confetti Falling. Oh my god, that song is awesome. The first time I heard that song, I annoyed my parents so much. Really late at night, I would run into their room and I would just like sing it and I would annoy them so much. They were like, shut up. They were getting so annoyed. But you know what? That song just gets in your head for like the rest of your life. And confetti has always been a fun thing for them. And I think that's like the perfect song for them. And I'm glad that they actually put it on this album. And it's amazing. And it's so much fun at the concert because they just like cover you in confetti. I have confetti from 3 Big Time Rush concerts. I am loaded, and so is Big Time Rush. They are loaded. Especially that Hender whore. Next song.
Just amazing. I'm gonna cry. I'm gonna cry. You can't see me. Doesn't beg for attention. She already knows. She's got the
You just ruined my moment, Bandit. That song. Just gets me in the zone, and I'm just teary because it's just so beautiful, and you can tell, I don't know if you can tell, but it's my favorite song on the album just because it's so amazing. Oh my god, you should have seen his eyes. Bandit's eyes went like when I started yelling. I mean, that song is amazing, and I mean it's kind of easy to tell that James wrote it about Halston. It's okay. It's such an amazing song, though. Ugh, God, I can't get over it. God. Oh, no. I just knocked off my computer cord thingy, and I have to plug it back in. What the fork? Got it. Back to amazing. That song is amazing. I just have to put it on repeat 24/7. Like, ugh, I just love that song. And when they sing it live, I'm just like, actually, I was so happy. They did sing it live at the Universal concert for the first time ever, and it was so amazing. I was just like fangirling unbelievably. And next song. Oh my god. That song will always be, in the Rusher world. Like, because the first time I heard this song, when the album had first come out, I cried just because the message, like, you can just hear it in the story. And just, I did cry the first time I heard it. I was like, are they serious? Are they, like, this is so sad. And, you know, it kind of tells a story that maybe Big Time Rush is getting old. But they're not, because they better not be. Oh my god, the last episode of Big Time Rush premiered. Well, like, on Wikipedia or whatever it is that it shows like the runtime, and it said November 28th, 2009 through July 25th, 2013. But then now, like a few days ago, my friend checked the little thingy and it said present. So they changed it to present. So they took away the end date. So I don't know. I don't know what the heck Big Time Rush is doing, but I hope they do another movie or a concert movie. They deserve a concert movie. And so do we. Like, hello, there are rushers worldwide that haven't seen Big Time Rush in concert, and I'm pretty sure they deserve to. But back to We Are. When they played it on the last episode, even my mom was sad. Do they want to kill us? Like, are they serious? It's just so sad. Why are they doing this to us? Okay, let's turn into a happy song. Let's find a happy song. Ooh, we're getting on to the bonus tracks. This should be fun. I was not singing this version, I was singing the original version. I mean, I do like this version, but hello, the original version was so freaking good! Like, who the hell would change it? That's right, Nickelodeon would. That was it with Rushers, I'm pretty sure, because I know, first of all, the KCAs, they totally rigged the votes. Like, they did, and Nickelodeon says they didn't, but they did. Every single award show is rigged. My mom used to work at a hotel in somewhere in New York City, and the Emmys were held there, and she said that the whole thing was totally bullshit. They were just saying it was just totally rigged, and like, because voting goes up till the very beginning of the show, but she said they were rehearsing the winners days before, so it's totally fake, and I just think that was it, and then other stuff, and then Love Me Again, you know what? Then Nickelodeon is hated by many people, and I'm pretty sure they have a lot less views now. So, in your face, Nickelodeon! Yeah, yeah. Oh, you didn't see me put my finger up. Yeah, Love Me Again. You know what? I just thought that when Big Time Rush made that music video and Carlos put it out there, I really thought, oh, wow, this is a more mature song. Maybe when it'll actually go down the radio this time. Or maybe when people hear it, they'll actually think Big Time Rush isn't just for little kids. It just pisses me off. And it was such a good song, too. Like, it had this awesome sound to it. And I'm really sad. And I know Big Time Rush is sad, because all of them loved the original version way better. Someone at Soundcheck asked James which one he liked, and James was like, oh, definitely the original. So I feel bad for them too. They're like controlled by Nickelodeon. At least they know that we understand, and we get pretty pissed off at people who mess with our boys. I hope this video isn't as long as the other one. Ooh, here we go. I love this song. Everybody loves this song. Just Getting Started. First of all, why couldn't they perform it on the tour? This song, it just has an amazing beat. It's like a club song, which makes me think it might be a Hender Whore song. But I don't know. I really love their bonus tracks. I think every single one of those songs are really good. That's another one of my favorites, which just comes very close to amazing. Next song. So is this one. Okay, when Kendall sang this in Big Time time, break out. Oh my god, I was just like, oh yes, just give me more. I really wish that they performed this live. I mean, I think this is another one, like, that we would start crying. But the funny thing is, it's a Kogan song. And then Logan was talking about how it's like Romeo and Juliet, so something's going on between them. I don't know. You know how head or whore he is. It doesn't matter who it is, he just wants them. Yeah, this song is probably loved by everybody too. My mom loves this song. So another thing I don't get is Ariana Grande is on Nickelodeon too. She was making out with Mac Miller in a music video and Nickelodeon didn't do anything about it. What the heck? It just pisses me off sometimes. Okay, next song. Okay. I love that line. Okay, especially when Kendall sings it, like, whoo. Lost in Love, that is an awesome song. It's also, like, reminds me of Carlexa, just because it's the first song that Alexa heard from Carlos. Ah, that song, I think that's another one of those songs that everybody loves. The Jake Miller rap, I spent so much time memorizing that. And then when I finally got it down, the set list came out for the summer tour, and they weren't performing that song. So you know how pissed off I was? Very pissed off. I didn't even bother to, like, learn the Song For You rap. I mean, I know some of it. I just don't really have it completely memorized. So cute. Kendall's so cute. He thinks he's Kim rap, but honestly, he's just too white. And it's just so the cutest thing ever. Like, just no. But yes. Next song. I think it's the last song. It is. You gotta step back and take a breath from a different point of view. Amazing. It's definitely a different sound for Big Time Rush, more like ukulele. That is not even a sound, it's an instrument, but it's more ukulele. All the bonus tracks on this album are songs that everyone will love, which I don't get why Nickelodeon didn't really take interest in that. But you know what? Nickelodeon sucks, so no one cares about them anymore. They can go suck those green ball suits. Yeah. Felt good to say. Yeah, no, it was fun to see you live, and it was funny because they were trying to, like, explain to us how to sing it, and they're just like, James is just being James. The whole album is like total summer songs, and I love it, and I just think it's perfect. It's probably my favorite album yet, just because it means a lot more to Big Time Rush. They wrote almost all of those songs. What the heck? I did not have this freckle on my leg before. I don't like it there. Get off. Okay. Thank you for watching. I'm hoping that this was kind of interesting. So follow my Twitter and Instagram. I'm just going to put it at the end because I don't feel like saying it. Bye.